Hi guys, in this episode I'm going to show you how to animate in Wick Editor. So let's get started. The first thing you need to have is a draw pad or drawing pad. I'm going to link that in the description. I use XP Pen G430S, which is a nice drawing pad. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is open Chrome and type in editor.wickeditor.com. I already made an animation here, so you can make similar animations after opening the Wickeditor. Press on new, yes, accept, and press on export. Press on editor settings and click on 1080p. That's the clearest form you can do in Wickeditor. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is draw a character for your animation. I'm going to draw a stick man. I already drawn a stick man here. And I'm going to draw the ground here. I don't usually draw the ground. Now, wait a second, he's floating. Yes. After you draw the ground, do the next thing, which is I'm going to draw a time bomb. You can draw whatever you want, but I'm just going to draw a time bomb. This is the pencil. These are the tools you need to draw for the you need to draw for animating. So he has a face now. This is optional, but I usually don't do it, so I'm taking out it. So I'm going to draw an ellipse here. This is the ground and this is the time bomb. The time bomb moves up and blows up when it reaches the ground. So on the first frame, select on onion skinning and go to the second frame and select if you want your character to move, and if you do the character movement exactly where your character should be, it's going to look a little bit ugly. I'm going to show you now why it's ugly. So I'm going to play it. It's just moving from here to here. It doesn't have the effect of moving with the steps. So I'm going to delete everything. And just near the before stick figure, onion skinning is a method that it's easy to make animations because of the movement. If you move it mistakenly here, your animation is going to look a little bit ugly. So I made it move. Now I'm going to make the ground. I made the ground now. I'm going to select on the brush tool. The time bomb is becoming up. It's coming up. I'm just going to repeat it like that. That line and the ground. He does know that the time bomb is coming up, but it's still coming up and he is escaping from that. That and the time bomb is coming up. While it's coming up, it's becoming smaller and coming. That now, now let's do it again in the second one, in the other figure, and the in the other frame. That, and let's do the ground now. Okay, I didn't select the line tool. Is escaping still. And it's here. Select the line tool and do the thing again. Okay, he escaped from that, but he's still going to become affected. I'm sorry. I'm going to put an ellipse here because it's easier and no need to draw. And now the thing comes up. Oh no. Now the thing blows up. It's going to blow up. Oh, I forgot the ground in the previous one. Okay, I'm now going to make the ground. Okay, now the stick man. I even forgot the stick man. And the stick man again. It blew up. Is falling down. It blew up and it made this big mess. Oh. Going to make the ground here. So these are your frames you made. This is really important. Dragon put this near the last frame you made. Let's see how our animation turned out. Okay, we need to make a little more frames. Okay, I made it. When you play it after making the half animation is going to look a bit of messy, but I'm okay with it. Because that's why I'm trying it. Okay. Now let's make the fire for it. Okay. I'm going to redo the fire. You can even add scripts for your Vicarator thing animation, but I'm not going to. It's a little bit hard, that's why I'm not going to show it in this tutorial. His hands became a lot thinner. Let's make it a little bit of that, and I'm going to make the ground again. In this thing, I'm going to stop it here and again continue. I'm going to make a circle here with using the pencil tool. It blew up a lot of the ground. Let's see how our animation turned out. You can see that the movements of the time bomb is a little bit smoother. I'm going to redo everything again. If you don't want that, and if you just want to copy and paste them, you can use the cursor thing, but I'm comfortable with the drawing tool because it's easier to control and do things. I prefer that. Want to make it again here? No. This doesn't work. Okay. Let's make this again a little bit again, and let's make the end thing. This time I'm making it with the freehand drawing because it's easier to make it. Okay. Oh, that turned out a little bit bad. That. Let's see our animation, and after that we are going to export our animations if it's good. If you want your animation to go a little bit slower, go to settings and select 10 FPS. Frames per second. Apply. And close it. Now I'm going to play it. Did turn out good. Now I'm going to make the end scene here. Now I'm going to select the cursor, and I'm going to select this, and I'm going to move it here. If you want to move your cursor or the selected thing, go to the middle circle and move it wherever you want to. I'm going to do it again here. Oh yeah, there's that text and done by Akshit. Now I'm going to select it with the cursor. And I'm going to put it here again like this. Copy that by pressing Ctrl C. I'm going to select this side. Ctrl V. I'm just going to do that for a couple of frames. And I'm going to drag it here. Now the thing, the red bar is really important, because if you want your animation to only play till the end, put it to the end. You can make buttons, you can make clips and all of those things. Now let's play it and check it out. The end. Now let's export it. I'm going to select on export and export video creates an mp4 file and export video. It's rendering it. Now let's see. It turned out nice. You can even add scripts and all of those things to make the animation interactive, but this is the basics. You can make your own animations with using your imagination. This is a nice tool for starting out for beginners. Thank you guys for watching. If you learn something new, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.